Earth on a Stick here. The following program isn't half as bad as some of the muck you've been getting lately. In fact, it's a bit of a wheeze, really. But for those of you who can't stop in for the whole thing, here's the speeded up version.
And now,
before you can say, it's the video show. Let's push the button marked idiot and see what comes out.
Hello.
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 Hello. And hello. And welcome to Show 7, the show that asks the question, why didn't we stop at Show 6? And reveals the secret of why Mrs. Kenworthy left her pants in the vestry and her vest in the pantry. Also on today's show, a semicolon will be dropping in for a brief pause, and Squeeze are here to sing their latest hit. And it goes like this, God damn it. Oh, that's what I call a limp.
The Indians send signals from the rocks above the pass. The cowboys take position in the bushes and the grass. The score is with the corporal, she is tied against a tree. She doesn't mind the language, it's the beating she don't need. She lets loose all the horses when the corporal is asleep. And he wakes to find the fire's dead and arrows in his axe. And Davy Crockett rides around and says it's cool for cats, it's cool for cats. The Sweeney's doing 90 cause they've got nowhere to go. They get a gang of villains in a shed up at Heathrow. They're counting out the fivers when the handcuffs lock again. In and out of Wandsworth with the numbers on their names. It's funny how the missus always looks a bleeding sane. And meanwhile at the station there's a couple of likely lads who swear like as your father and they're very cool for cats, they're cool for cats. To change the mood a little I've been posing down the pub. I'm seeing my reflection, I'm looking slightly rough. I fancy this, I fancy that, I wanna be so fresh. I'll give a little muscle and I'll spend a little cash. But all I get is bitter and a nasty little rash. And by the time I'm sober, I've forgotten what I've had. And everybody tells me that it's cool to be a cat, cool for cats. Questions that she hangs onto the wall. I kiss her for the first time and then I take her home. I'm invited in for coffee and I give the dog a bone. She likes to go to discos but she's never on her own. I said I'll see you later and I'll give her some old chat. But it's not like they on the TV when it's cool for cats, it's cool for cats.
Hello, Mia viewers. Sid Snot here. I said to my bird Deirdre last night, here, Deird, your knickers are coming down. She said, how do you know? I said, I just decided.
And now, Captain Kremen of Star Corps.
Bursting onto the scene with the grunge gun force of 50 megathrobs.
Hi kids, Kremen here. Remember how in the last episode, the giant banana was rampaging across the globe, heading for New York? But I had a plan. If we evacuate New York and just have you standing alone on Brooklyn Bridge looking voluptuous, it's bound to be extremely attracted by you. And as it makes its way towards you, we'll nab it from behind. Despite Carla's red, white, and blue blood, I noticed as I spoke that she turned a peculiar white color. Are you ill?
I hope so. I'd hate to feel like this if I was well.
Meanwhile, the radio kept up the dreadful news.
Several giant radishes have been seen south of Illinois. There'll be a repeat later this evening.
As the ship hurtled towards the danger zone, I checked out the crew.
Well, men, this assignment will test us to our utmost limits.
Yes, Captain.
It's perhaps our most dangerous mission ever, men.
Yes, Captain.
Anyone like to back out?
Yes, Captain.
I'll pretend I didn't hear that.
Oh, Captain.
Yes?
Carla would like to see you in the galley.
Oh, good. Say,
why?
Haven't I seen your face somewhere else?
No, Captain. It's always been here on the front of my head.
I made my way to the galley, where Carla had been trying out her culinary skills on our nuclear-powered Arga.
Oh, hi, Captain. I'm cooking you some beans.
Carla, why are your ankles completely swathed in bandages?
Well, it said in the instructions, to heat contents, stand in boiling water for 15 minutes.
A lump went to my brain. How could an idiot be so attractive? Carla?
Yes, Captain?
Come here, my little cosmic cherub. Let me cuddle your heaving bosom.
Okay.
Before I fed her to the giant banana, I decided to give Carla one of the world's great treats. Me.
Will Kremen's plan work, or will the giant banana get its just desserts? Find out in next week's limb-wrenching episode.
Howdy, friends, and welcome to the Bushwhacker's Buttock, where we've come for a little drinky-poo. Better late than never. Hey, barman, give me a short on the rocks. Oh, it's a short. But where are the rocks? Give me some rocks!
Hello, my little Villavance. Welcome to my nutty kitchen. Tonight, I am going to create for you my culinary concoction de la maison fantastique. Here, before your very eyes, I will mix up some hot cozy beans. Now you say, instant. Glue your eyes to your TV screen. I just add the water, and voila! Oh, they look so delicious. I think I will drink them all down. I feel like a new man. I must go out and get one. Au revoir, my little avocado vinaigrettes.